because the internet would not stop complaining, developer From Software will release a PC version of its hardcore role-playing fantasy game Dark Souls on August 24th. It'll include all the content of the original version, plus some extras. And because it's just like the original, that means it's a really unforgiving experience. You will die a lot, and that's by design. Death teaches you the value of precision movement. The constant risk forces you to pay attention if you want to make any progress. You can't play this game on autopilot. Every movement, every input matters, and even minor missteps can easily turn into disasters. The added content in the Prepare to Die edition is no different. You'll fight through roughly 10 new hours of gameplay, which includes fights against new enemies and bosses. In an added forest zone, you'll square off against hellish scarecrows that cluster together in packs. If you walk casually around the zone, you'll aggro many at once and probably wind up dead as they stab you. Chances are you'll probably also grab the attention of stone golems wandering around the same area. They're slower than the scarecrows, but can absolutely flatten you if you can't dodge away from their mace swings. Still, as long as you're careful and don't aggro too many at once, these guys aren't anywhere close to as challenging as the new bosses. The Sanctuary Guardian, a chimera-like creature, prowls around a circular boss chamber. He can fly, rapidly slash, and spit high-damage orbs of lightning and generally make your life incredibly difficult to enjoy. Knight Artorias is even more difficult as he moves extremely fast. His sword slashes are challenging enough to dodge, but when you factor in his long-distance dive bomb attacks, the encounter can get hectic really quickly. Expect to get cut down in a hurry until you fought him a few times and had a chance to learn his attack patterns. Though the PC version of Dark Souls is playable with a mouse and keyboard, the controls weren't optimized in the preview build we played, so we'll have to wait until launch to see how well they work. Playing with a 360 gamepad, though, seemed to work just fine. In case you already own Dark Souls on console, the new Artorias of the Abyss content will be made available sometime later on for Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3 for around $15. For more on Dark Souls, check out IGN.com.